Hey everyone, I made a video recently about Affinity by Canva, the new Affinity, this one right here, where I go over all the tools in Vector, the Vector side of it, and kind of show you where to get it for free and everything like that. But I mentioned in that video that I wish there was a vectorizer and a upscaler, and those of you that commented that there actually is one in there, so or both of those in there. So in this video, I'm gonna show you what it's called. It's actually called Image Trace. And I think the other one's called Super Image or something like that. We'll find out here. So they do vectorize in Affinity, woo, and they also upscale. So I'm gonna show you how to use both with AI designs, because I think that's what you may be using it for. I'm not gonna do an AI design in Canva, although you can do that in Affinity with Canva, but I'm gonna just drag in one that I did with ChatGPT and see how it works there and kind of show you the pros and cons and basically first looks at it, because I haven't played with it too much. We're gonna learn about it here in this video. So if that's what you wanna do, stay tuned and we'll see how it works together. All right, so here I am in the new Affinity. You can tell that it's the new Affinity because vector, pixel, layout. And if you haven't seen my video, I would watch that first. I'll put that up here where I kind of show you how to start a new design and everything. We're just jumping right in here with the artboard. I have two here, before and after, because I want to show you what it does. So first, let's vectorize something. And the thing I'm going to do is just this simple one that I showed in my other video, this watermelon. You can see it's kind of small. I'm going to actually make it bigger like this. And this one's really simple. Simple shapes, simple lines, not very complex. So I want to do that first, and then I'll do something that's a little more complex and see how it does. So I'm going to do a before and after. So this is after. This is before. You can see it is just a JPEG. I can't click on it. It's not a vector, although it's in a vector style. It's not a vector. But the way to make this a vector, to vectorize it, is you can come here to Vector and then Image Trace. I really wish Image Trace was up here, Affinity, if you're listening, or down over here on the side, but I'm glad that we have it. Vector. All right, Image Trace, and let's just do it right here. You can see here Assistant, the Assistant rasterized the layer you previously had selected because it was not a raster layer. Oh, all right. I think it actually did it though. Let's see. Let's click on here, double click. Yeah, it gave me that warning, but it actually did it. So you can see, it is now pixels. So now that it's pixels, this whole thing is a box. I can delete it. There's another white box for some reason. I can delete it. But look, they're all pixels. It did it that fast. And let's zoom into the quality. I mean, gosh, I think it got everything. And I think it got everything because this is done in a vector style. And of course, it made it a lot easier with less colors and everything. But I can come in here. Let's see. I can change. So it has all the black. Like if I want this a different color, the nice thing about having it a vector is all of this, I can make it like a pure yellow if I wanted to. It's probably not going to show up on white as well as what it was, but I can always go back. I can come in here, like let's say, wait, these should have been black, right? I can take my eyedropper and make it the same color as that. Boom. So it's really cool to have vectors in here that I can kind of manipulate and do it. And let's see, one more thing. Let's change the background to make sure that it's truly transparent. So I'm gonna do that. So yeah, so one of the things that you can see right away when it's a vector is that that is not the background. So let's see if I can just remove it. I doubt it, yeah. So what we're gonna have to do is select the black like this and select that and then do this kind of Boolean effects where you subtract it. And now it's totally knocked out. I think we're gonna have to do the same for these white ones here as well, because if we just delete it, yeah, it's gonna be black. So we'll do that. And since they're in the front, and we know they're in the front because we can see it, we'll pick the black as well. And I think we can do it all together. Yep, there we go. So really cool. Now this is a total vector. I can change the colors if I want to. I can make these lines go all the way up if I want to. I can add vector things to it. So if I have my pencil tool, for example, I can come in, or pen tool, I can come in here and like draw on top of it. So let's say I go here and here. I want to continue that green line, the darker green line here. I can just come in here, copy this, boom, right? And kind of add to it. And so it kind of continues there. And I could have done the same here and so on. Just really cool. This one, this seed right here probably needs to be the same color as the other seeds. Boom. Check that out. All right, so that's a simple one. Let's see what happens when I do something a little more complex. All right, so here it is. I showed this one in my last video as well. Although this does look like a vector style art, like the other one, it's a little more complex because we have overlapping colors here. We have all the colors of the rainbow here. I think it's just a little more complex. So let's see how Image Trace does with this. Before and after, I'm going to pull up Image Trace again, like this. And you'll notice I didn't do this the last time because it just was perfect. But look at this edge threshold and curve fitting tolerance. I'm going to just put it at 50 and 50, just so you can see. You can also type in here, 50, tab, 50. And this is what it does. It's missing some colors over here, although the lines look nice. You may want to do that, but you can see it kind of breaks apart over there. So let's take a look what happens now that we're zoomed in and we kind of know what it looks like. I'm going to take this edge threshold all the way down, give it a minute, and you see it does some funky things. So you don't want it at zero. I'm going to pull it up to 16, and we got back the color a little bit, but not on this side. And this is still kind of rough. Like, let's move this down a little bit using the space bar, the hand tool. Look at the colors kind of mix here. So I'm gonna go maybe to 10, 6. So you kind of have to play with this edge threshold to something that you want. And it's still not great. Like, I'm not getting what I want here with these colors continuing. Maybe it's the curve fitting tolerance. Let's take that to 0. See what happens. Nothing really. Let's go all the way to 100. Let's see if that did anything. Not really. So yeah, not great, but I'm gonna try maybe 50 and 50, 57, 56, and let's just give it, see what happens. So I'm gonna hit apply. And did it make it a vector first of all? Yes, I can move this. It's totally a vector now. It probably has a white background. No, let's see. No, it doesn't, the whole thing. Yeah, these are nice. The nice thing about having these as a vector is I could change the color of these and just make them stand out. Maybe they should be the same color as that, right? But you can see before and after, I'm missing this line here. It's not perfect. Like the other one was really, really close. This one, the color here before and after kind of knocked it out. And so you could be okay with that, or you could upscale this. So I'm thinking maybe this is the time that we should learn about the upscale. So I'm going to take this vector one out, delete. I'm going to put a new one after here. And let's see if upscaling helps. Now, the upscale thing is not called Image Trace, and it's in the Canva AI, and I believe it's called Super Enhance, Super Resolution Tool. I knew it was super in there. So Super Resolution Tool. I'm gonna click on it, and it says here you need to fix your settings. So first time I'm using it, I'm gonna hit Settings. And I'm gonna have to install it. And you have to have a pro account, which I do, luckily. So I'm gonna hit install. I don't know if I'm gonna have to restart, but oh, it already did it. Okay, let's do this. Let's try this again. Super resolution. I don't know how much it upscales it. I may have to click learn more. In fact, let's do that together. Super resolution tool. Before and after, looks good. Let's see, does it do it 4x, 2x? Best study, low quality, blah, 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 scaling, drag, doesn't really say. Okay, maybe I have to do further. things. Okay, but let's do super resolution. And whoa, it gives you some kind of before and after thing. That's gonna be cool. Okay. And hopefully, since I increase the resolution, adding more pixels to it, that when I do my image trace, it'll have a better time to trace it or vectorize it, right? So a lot of times you have to do this with AI anyway, is to upscale it and then vectorize it to get a better thing. So I'm hoping that that's the case here. So it may take a little while because it's a big file. I'll come back when it's done it. All right, I'm back, and that way took way too long, but the results are in. You can see before and after. I'm gonna zoom in here, and it's nice that you can see before and after here. So I'm gonna take this. I believe you can move it, yeah. So I don't know if it did that much difference, to be honest. Let's see. It looks almost exactly the same, but I'm gonna take that off. And this is the upscaled one. I'm gonna do the image trace on it. And if it doesn't work, I have another one that will do it. But let's go vector image trace to see if my thoughts are correct. And it does look slightly better, actually. I don't know. Let's go back down here. Will it bring in the color? I'm gonna start pulling this back down. All the way down. Okay, it does the same thing and doesn't get the color that I need on the eyes. See right there, it kind of breaks it down, and I don't know about having all of that right there, but I do like having the color that it does. It kind of messed up the color here on the nose, so maybe let's go incrementally 5%. Now see, 5% takes it out. 4%. Yeah, not great. I don't know if this helps here going down. Anyway, let's do one, and I'll show you. We'll do the super enhance on something else, but let's just do it 50-50 here, just so you can see that it's pretty good. I'm gonna apply it, and I mean, it does a decent job. It's still kind of straight, but it struggled with some of the colors here on the eye, and that's fine. Not fine, but it's okay because it's a vector, you know, right here. I can continue to draw on here. Like before this, I would have to trace everything on my own. This time I can actually trace, like let's say I want this eye here like this. I can use the pen tool and come in here and go like this, you know, like that. And so on, and maybe make my own, draw it around and make it, and then apply it to the, I'm not gonna do it here, but I could easily do that and then just drop it on this one, and you know, the black line's still here and everything, so it needs a little bit of cleanup, but not totally bad. I wanna show you a before and after of the image enhanced, just so, now this one, it didn't do anything because it was already enhanced. It was already 6,000 pixels, which I should have known. Don't do an image enhance on something that big, but I'm gonna do an image enhance on something smaller here. I brought this in, and you can see it's kind of pixelated. If we go in here, like look at that. So I'm gonna do this and this here, and we'll do a before and after, and this shouldn't take as long because it's not as big. This one is probably 1,000 pixels. So I'm gonna do the same thing, Canva AI. We're gonna go to the super resolution tool now that I have it. I'm gonna hit on it, and you can see it's going a lot faster than the other one. The other one was 6,000 pixels. And so this is mainly made for something that's already small, the 1024 by 1024, if you haven't done resolution on it. So my bad, I did that wrong on that last one. It was already enhanced, and of course, it's not gonna enhance it anymore because it was already so big. So you can see this one's moving a lot quicker. I think this tool is made for that, and that now we can see the real before and after. Okay, so let me take this bar here. Okay, oh, it's freaking out on here. After, you can see, like right here. I think it's because of my zoom. There we go. I guess it doesn't want me to zoom. I'll zoom in with my video that you can see. So before and after, check it out. A lot cleaner. And so this is what you would do and then vectorize it. So so the resolution looks pretty good. I think it looks better than it did before. Let's see before and after. Can't really tell that much, but hopefully this image trace, let's go to vector. Oh, I gotta click on it first. Vector, image trace, and then let's look at this here, this tolerance, edge tolerance thing. Curved here, let's see. So I have it max 100, 100. I don't know if I like that curve. Let's go to zero. No, not liking that either. It's too fuzzy. And this one adds too many of the pixels. So I don't know why the watermelon one worked great. So I guess it's hit and miss. Yeah, I definitely don't want zero. 50 on here, kind of not solid on here. I think the best would be 100 and 100 on here, but I don't like this edge here. I want the curves better, but it's not doing the straight thing on here. So sometimes it's good and sometimes it isn't. I guess I'm gonna hit apply on this one right here. And I like that the apply is super quick. But you can see when I click on here, and if this is pixels, yeah, I might have to play around with that. So this one didn't turn out like I wanted to, but it is there. So you're gonna have to play around with those toggles. I think sometimes it works great. You can see this one kind of took out the color here and didn't do it as well. So. Not sure. Sometimes I think you just have to play around with both the upscale and the vectorizing. Like I said, the watermelon one turned out the best. It was super easy. But I thought this one is more vector as well. But for some reason, I think that when the colors are too similar, like this is brown and brown, it's getting kind of confused here. And it totally left out that when it should be here and so on. So. There it is. It has the tools. Does it need some refinement? Yes, I think it can be refined a little bit better. But the good thing is that it's there. When we never had it before, we have both of these. And now you know where to find it. The vector image trace is the vectorizer. So you need to click on it first, go to vector image trace. And then if you want to upscale it, you go to Canva AI. You'll have to have a premium account or pro account of Canva, and it's this one right here, super resolution. So there you go, upscale and vectorizer in Affinity for free. Well, the vector image trace is free. Canva, if you have a pro account, not free, but pretty cool that we have it. So there you go, that's my short tutorial on vectorizer or image trace and upscaling, which is the super resolution. Now that it's in Canva, thanks so much for leaving those comments. If there's other things that I missed that I should be showing in another video, let me know that in the comments as well. Thanks for all your help. And if you want to see that first video that I did, I'll put that one right here. It's kind of more of a walkthrough on the vector side of it, all the tools on the left-hand sidebar. I will be trying to make the other ones for the pixel and the layout one, which is kind of like Photoshop and InDesign on the Adobe side. So thanks again for watching. And as always, keep curating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.